Scotty Nguyen, baby. Cause you're also sentimental, I'm a diver. Wishing that focus on better. If you want, I'm sure it's just a little piece of heaven. I've been cooked, I've been faded, I was born by the rib. All the smoke in the air.
Hello, world. It's day two. I'm going to merge. Join Rom on day three. Way to go yesterday, Rom. 195K going into day three. I think that's the most either of us have ever bagged going into day three, so let's go. I'm going to try to follow those footsteps and bag somewhere around there, hopefully, or more. You know, like last night I was up and just excited for this and just hoping to bag like 400, 500. But if I just bag, I'll be happy. Let's go. Woke up and feel this way. I ain't trying to feel this way today. I don't think I can take this pain. I'm in my head again. Someone tell me why I feel this way. Everything in my life right now been great. Can't see where to go cause it all looks great. I'm in my head again, I'm sorry. No, I don't understand what could be the issue. Everything good, I'm good, was missing. I've been in my head trying to get the picture. Is it just me, everybody getting dizzy?
Hey. Oh, what a number. What a great number. Scotty Nguyen, baby. Start to the day. We've got 20 minutes till break. I've got 76K, which I mean, like, yeah, I came in with 90, so it's not that much less. But I mean, man, like, I cannot win a hand. I just 3-bet right now with ace queen suited, and I got 4-bet, so I just had to lay it down. There was one where Under the Gun, who's a tighter player, opened to 1700, folds to me in the small blind. I have ace queen. Oh, I call. Guy to my left who had just bought in, he had been playing for like five hands, also calls in the big blind. I go through right of the flop, and it's 9-10-10 with two clubs. It goes check, check, check. Turn comes queen of clubs, brings a third club. I have no ace of clubs, so I have ace queen with no club. I check. Guy to my left bets 3,500, and then Under the Gun, who's a tighter player, calls. So I just have to fold right here. River comes four, and then the guy to my left bets 11K, and then that guy, the tight player Under the Gun, calls. Guy to my left has nines. He flopped nines full of tens. So a great fold there to save some chips, but, man, I really need to pick something up and just start go in the right direction. It's such a long tournament. I'm not in bad shape at all. Just want to feel like I'm gaining chips and winning. So that's all.
Sun don't shine on the west side. She wish nobody would have left to be. Mama tried not to let her.
Hit the first break. We got 84.5 from 90.1. Got a little bit back there at the very end. Went two pots that whole level, blind versus blind, both from the big blind. They're just saving all my rum good for later. Good thing I was able to stay afloat right there. See you on the next break. I like.
choice. You left a couple weeks ago, why can't I enjoy the emptiness you went and left up in that home? I wanna make love, you wanna move. Like, please take off your makeup. Said you wanna groove. I can never hate her. Pull me up a deuce, ay. If I wanna save her, she gon' have to move, ay. I'm gon' make a wake up.
So we're on the second break of the day, day two, in the main event. 42.2, that was a horrible level. 500 and 1,000, and under the gun plus one opens to 2,100. I look at aces plus two. The guy in the cutoff and on the button are the most aggressive players on our table. They're three betting a lot. So I just call right here with pocket aces, hoping to get a three bet from either one of them. Cutoff ends up just calling, and so does the button. Big blind calls. We go five way to the flop. We hate that. Flop comes king 8-9 with two diamonds and a heart. It goes check, check to me. And I want to just start putting chips in right here and just narrowing down the field. So I bet 4,500. Cutoff calls, button calls, big blind folds, and original razor calls. So I only lose one player right there. We're still four way going to the turn. Turn comes two of hearts, which is so much better for me than anyone else. I feel like the cutoff or the button would have raised with two pair if they had like king 9 or 8 9. Either of them would have raised right there. So I feel like my hand is definitely still ahead. Plus one checks. I bet 11.5K. Cutoff folds, button calls, and then plus one fold. So we're heads up going to the river, which comes king of clubs. I hate this card, but I really want to show my hand down. So I just go ahead and bet 5,200, which is like 10% of the pot. He calls fairly quickly. I show aces, and I thought I was good for a second. He kind of slow rolled me, and then he shows ace king. And he goes on to say, like, the only reason I didn't three bet here was because I three bet this hand literally the previous two hands in a row and lost two big pots. I didn't want to three bet for a third time in a row and lose chips with ace king again. So that was his reasoning for not three betting, which in hindsight, it actually probably saved my tournament life. If he three bets right there, I'm going to four bet and he's not going to fold. A little bit later, he ended up getting it all in with ace king. It goes open and then a shove for 27K. He cold calls 27K from the cutoff. And then the original opener shoves for like 135,000. Over 100 big blinds he shoves. And he ends up calling with ace king over there and then wins. He beats kings in that spot. Just incredible. So, yeah, I probably just would have ended up going bust if the hand played out any different. I think I actually lost the minimum. But, yeah, just really unfortunate. Hits the 4% shot on the river. Oh, man, so brutal. I was at right around 50K after that hand. And now I have 42.2. Yeah, that was a brutal one. Hit like 4% going to the river. Spiked the 4%. Still fine. I mean, still positive. Still going to run it up.
Hold on, please. Hold on. I need to take a picture of this. Hold on. Again.
Nobody knows what's wrong.
knows, I'm on it, boy. Nobody knows, nobody knows, nobody knows. Nobody knows, nobody knows. Nobody knows, nobody knows. Nobody knows, nobody knows.
We're on dinner break, and I've got 28,000. Really brutal day. I can't flop a pair. I can't get anything that I haven't recovered since losing with aces to ace king, but still positive. Still got like 18, 19 big blinds. Definitely trying really hard to spin it up. I could have busted many times before this, and the fact that I'm still in just shows how hard I'm battling. Yeah, I mean, I'm gonna do my best to find a double spot and then just go from there. Feeling of the year. It's busting the main event. A guy who opens quite often, opened to 3,000, folds to me in the small blind. I three bet jam at 29.5K. I have ace queen O. Guy in the big blind directly to my left reshoves 200,000. And then the guy who had originally opened goes into the tank for a while and then ends up calling as well. They both have ace king. I have ace queen. Flop came jack 9-9. I turn open into straight draw and then just brick river. Hate busting this tournament. Rom's still in. I have a great feeling about Rom. I feel like he's gonna go to day 7 at the minimum. I still got that sweat. Appreciate everyone who came along the ride with me. We're just gonna have to wait for next year to win this one. It'll be bigger next year, so that's what I'm waiting for anyways. Rom will win this one. I'll win it next year. We still got a lot of stuff coming on the vlog, so stay tuned. Ugly to bust. It was just one of those days. I mean, literally, I could not get anything going. After I lost the hand with aces versus ace king, just nothing could be done. Good game. We'll see you tomorrow, day 3, as Rom makes it into day 4.